Okay, here it is, May 28th, and it's a good thing I'm in no hurry to finish this van because it's only been 1 or 2 or 6 months, something like that. It's the last time I did anything. Well, yesterday, actually, I started to do a little bit because I need to put the vapor barrier in. So I think you saw one of the last videos where I put down the insulation and the 2x2s and all that kind of neat stuff. Here's what I did. Oh, actually, let me show you first. Here's that vapor barrier that I have. That's a cutoff that I had. And then I used this silver kind of tape to tape it down. And let me go ahead and show you what it looks like. Also, I'm using the really super steady mode here, so hopefully it's coming out okay. So there it is. And I went up the edges a little bit. Obviously, I don't have to go up that high, but I thought, you know what? I have there's 4 foot wide. So I went from all the way up there down to about halfway, and then I had some overlap, and I went up the other side another 4 feet. And then I, just for kicks and giggles, I did a center one also, and then taped it. No, I didn't tape it all the way, but I taped it pretty much. Like for instance, over here, I didn't tape this, but folding it down, that's good enough for now. Since I'm not going to be finishing this for a long time, although I did kind of tape it down over here, as you can see. Periodically taped it in the front. Now what I'm going to do now, and that's why I'm recording, is I'm going to be putting the 4x8 sheet of plywoods in here. I think they're 3/8. They're not really that thick. I didn't think I need anything that thick for the floor since I already have a pretty good base here. So let me go ahead and I'm going to let this roll and maybe I'll speed it up or something as we get further down. I'm going to try and figure out where I'm going to put this at. I don't know if you can see, but you know, like for instance, right here is a cross member, and then here's one that's going, face it this way. You can kind of see it going up that way. Let's see if this will work. I'm not sure. I have to come up here and look in the viewfinder to see what it's doing. Yeah, let's try that. Although this is a nice little tripod. It's a bendy one. So hopefully it'll stay in place so you can see what's going on. Alright. That's good. Let me get out of the way here. Let me bring in the first one. Challenge here is going to be placing it down without ripping that vapor barrier. Let's see. I'll try to push it up there as much as I can. Nope, that's not gonna work. Alright. Alright. Trying to go nice and easy. I don't wanna break or rip anything. So as you can see, one sheet's gonna fit on here just nicely, and then I'll have to rip up the other ones so they can fit around. I thought the best way to do this would be to put the largest piece that's not cut in as much the center as possible. The reason being is that, I don't know if you can, come on, right here. Over here, I think you can see that, off to the driver's side, behind the driver's seat, going back to, I guess, right about here or so, that's going to be my couch slash bed. So, obviously, if I have a split in the plywood, it's not going to be seen over here, where if I had it in the middle, it not only would be seen, but it could potentially be a weak point. So that's why I'm kind of doing an offset, not putting right in the straight in the middle. And then over here, and you can't see it, but over here is where the step up to the side door is. I'm going to have the edge of the plywood right up against that, just so that there's no potential of weakness on that side. Okay, so let me bring this all the way in nice and easy. Don't want to drag anything. Okay, good. There it is. Now, question is, will I move it? I think I will move it over a little bit. And I don't know if you can see, but right over there on the passenger side wheel well, I have it right up against it, but if I do that, if I leave it there, then it's getting into the well of where the step is going to be. I don't know what that was. So anyways, I think I like my idea better of pushing it over. Well, let's see. I've seen some people where they leave a little bit of overhang there, and then they just step up, and it's not so bad, because what I plan on doing is put like a doorway on the sliding door, so that actually may work. I think I'll leave it here. All right, so I need to actually move over a little bit. I'm gonna get right up against that. Okay. Now the question. I don't know so much question. What I need to do now is let me find out which screws can I use. Again, I want to make sure I don't use too long of ones. Not that it's going to be a problem going into the metal here and into the van itself, but there's no need to, because as long as I get attached to the 2x2s, those things are very strongly attached. Yeah, I think these will work best. I have some old drywall screws that will work just fine. Again, I don't think I need to really do much of a support on this, because once these screws are in and in place, it's not going to fly around, so I'm not going to put that many in. I'll put enough, but not a lot. One of the things you probably didn't notice too, as I put this plywood in here, is that it's already painted. Well, not painted well, but it does have a coat of paint on there, and that I did so that even if moisture did come down, at least it would have some protection with the paint. And this is a, oh gosh, I forget the name brand. I probably had it on my other videos, but it's supposed to stop any kind of mold and mildew. Kilts? Something like that? Anyways, that's one thing that is always a concern for people who are in vans and box trucks and all that kind of stuff, is mold and mildew. So that's exactly why I'm doing as much as I can do. I have the vapor barrier here, treat the plywood that's going to be on there, and hopefully reduce any mold and mildew that may occur. I think I'll stop this here. And I will go ahead and start screwing this plywood down.
Okay.
Okay, well, the good thing about not being rushed is it looks like it's going to be raining here in the next half hour, and I got some cutting to do because I need to get a 4x8 sheets I have. I have to cut it so it will fit over there and fit over there and fit down here and all the way across. So because of that, I don't want to feel rushed, and I'm in no great big hurry, so I think I'll wait until we don't have rain in the near future. So that's what it looks like for now. It's getting there. That's okay, because like I said, I'm putting the floor down now, and it's gonna stay rough because I'm gonna be using it to move next year, so there's no need to you know, put a nice floor down and start all the rest of it. So that's it for now. So I'm gonna sign off. See ya. Probably Sunday, maybe Monday. It is a 5-day weekend. Yay. All right. See ya. Okay. Finally got the floor down, as you can see. And the great thing about that silver tape, it hides all my mistakes. Mistakes? No. They weren't mistakes. They were opportunities for greatness. Yes, that's it. Opportunities for greatness. That's the ticket. So yeah, here it is. It's a 3/8 inch plywood, and with the kills, just one coat I think I put on there. I didn't put a lot. Just wanted to get enough to get, so that I make sure I didn't, you know, have any algae and all, well, mold, really, not so much algae, if water got on here. But then I think what I will probably do, and I'm not doing it right now because I'm going to be moving and using this to move all my stuff to wherever I end up at. After I move and I start building this out, then I will go ahead and here I am. I will go ahead and put something else down on top of this. But I think what I was looking at doing is the workout foam. You know, it has the interlocking little things that they put to have 2x2 squares or whatever. I'm thinking of doing that only because that would give a little bit of a give when you're standing in here for a while. And also what I plan on doing too is getting that silver lining again and put that down on top of the plywood here, and then go ahead and put that other those 2x2s down, which will then make it hopefully a very effective for any kind of mold or mildew, because there should be no wetness getting below the flooring here. So I think that's it. I don't know if you can hear in the background that hum. Let me kind of walk back here. You can kind of see. Yeah, I know I've got a messy patio. Need to clean it up. Can you hear that? It's coming from the trees and stuff. Dang, gotta mow the lawn again. Guys are all over the place. Just one flew right by me. From that guy right there. Can I focus in on that? Let's see. Hopefully that focuses in. I don't see too many right here. Don't hear them. They're just really loud back here. Yeah, you probably can't see it, but I can see them flying around in the tree up there. Let's see if I can change the telephoto on this. Gotta love the cicadas. Yay! Anyways, that's about it for now. Oh my gosh, it's coming in loud. We'll see you later. I think that's gonna be all I'm gonna be doing to the van for a while. So yeah, at least for the next year. And then hopefully I'll be moved and then I can start really building it out. All right, see ya, bye.